Hello, this is Dr. Antin from RD Physics, and this is the BB1 boombox. It's not really a box, nor does it produce a lot of boom. But let's not let that get in the way of a good story. Stay tuned and find out what's so special about it. BB1 here is a battery-less portable speaker. Why don't we want a battery in a portable speaker? Well, it seems like all things are getting now wireless and we have more and more batteries inside our equipment and it's not sustainable. We want to save money and we want to save the planet. So we're introducing a concept for a battery-less portable speaker. If you look at the power tool manufacturers, they don't sell their power tools with a battery. Instead, you buy a separate set that has a charger and maybe two batteries, and those go to all of your power tools. So the first idea was to use a power tool battery to power the boom box, but then the interface is a bit cumbersome and there are several different brands. But then we looked at what phone manufacturers are doing. So when you buy even an expensive phone, it does not come with a charger anymore. That's because people already have tons of chargers lying around. And that gave us the idea. What if we could do a portable speaker using USB power? That way, you have the option of powering it externally using a power bank like this, or one of those phone chargers that you have lying around like this, or you can just plug it in your laptop USB port or whatever USB port you have around. So quite convenient when you don't have an internal battery and want to power it externally using USB power. Now, the BB1 here is based on our SW2 subwoofer, so it actually has the same spherical 5-liter enclosure and it has the same passive resonator at the bottom here. But instead of having an active subwoofer driver at the top, it has a handle, a USB port, 2 3-inch full-range drivers, and then a wall mount at the back. Let's now quickly go through the components, what we've chosen. So this is a Peerless 3-inch aluminium cone full-range driver. Inside here is a Wandom Bluetooth receiver amplifier that can use a voltage supply of only 5 volts, so that's suitable for our USB power. Obviously, it doesn't give out a lot of power, so we have only a few watts per channel to use. And the interesting question is then, does it produce enough sound pressure? Not everything has to be printed. So over here we have a drawer handle from IKEA. You can find them almost everywhere around the world. And in the back we have a wall mount from Genelec, and you can find those in most countries as well. And at the bottom we have the Dayton Audio 6.5-inch passive radiator, which also acts as a service hatch. So when you remove this, you have easy access inside. You can assemble and connect everything. The USB port here is from eBay. This one is printed from foaming PLA, so it's a kind of a PLA material that expands at the extruder when you heat it up, and you can control the expansion by controlling the temperature. And for this one, we used maximum expansion. I believe the nozzle temperature was about 240 degrees centigrade, and that way we were only using 60% flow to get a full width extrusion. The benefit of using foaming PLA is that we can use multiple wall lines without the weight or the material cost getting out of hand. So this whole thing weighs only 1.2 kilograms and most of it is from the magnets of the drivers. So very light to carry around. This is one of those cases where the measurements don't really tell the sound quality. When you do the measurements, you see that the tuning of the passive resonator is way too low. It's about 55 hertz, while the response starts to decline already at 100 hertz. So one could say that it's a too low tune, but actually when you listen to it, the passive resonator, you can restrain it with your hands and see the effect of the passive resonator. It really adds to that low bass region. So although the measurements show that we don't have a lot of low frequency extension, actually listening to it, I would say that the bass extension is one of these strong points. The mid-range looks fine, but then it doesn't sound that great. the high frequencies, there's a lot of beaming and a peak around 10k hertz, which is typical for a 3-inch full range driver. These are towed out a bit, so the idea is to listen mostly off axis, but actually when listening, we noticed that on axis is where we have the best sound despite the peak at the high frequencies. Since this thing looks like something the Russians would send out to space, I think it's only fitting that we listen to some Russian hard bass.
All rise for hard bass. Never fear, war is secure. Ready, let's go. Why squats, chicken breaky, cold compote with chibureki. Always moving, never done. Such is life, it's not around. Take a ride, dragon down, fingers up and windows down. Hot pulling in some glass, trade around and pop a bar.
Thanks for watching. You can find the affiliate links for the components down in the description. And we are looking to make a version 2 of this with improved drivers. So if you have any recommendations of 3-inch full-range drivers with high sensitivity, drop your comments below. And I'll see you next time. Cheers.